All right, so I wanted to end Deermas with a list of my personal 10 military anime that I think you would all enjoy. After all, it's June, the month of war, and nothing else. So this isn't a top 10 list as much as I'd like to use that in the title to get views. So they're not in any particular order, but I know people like lists for some reason, so I'll be starting from 10. Now, to be on the list, these shows have to have a predominant military theme or center around something military related. As such, I'm not gonna include mecha type shows because that itself is kind of for another time since it's a different genre. Alright, starting off at 10, for the first entry we have Zipang or Zipang. I don't really know how to pronounce it. Pronounce it however the heck you like. It's about a JSDF guided missile cruiser that gets sent to the past into World War II during the Battle of Midway. I like this one because it's historical sci-fi with some drama thrown in. It looks kind of old, but it aired in 2004-2005. Overall, I really enjoyed this one. It has a total of 26 episodes with one season, and that's just about it for that one. Alright, next we have Code Geass, Lelouch of the Rebellion. Okay, I know I said I wouldn't include any mechas, but this one's kind of a little bit different. It does have mechas in it, but it's not really about them for the most part. It's more about tactics and political maneuvering and, you know, getting into people's heads, things like that. Literally, sometimes. Nonetheless, the mechas are still there. What I like about this, though, is that it's really smart. Like, the characters aren't stupid for the sake of the plot. Well, not too much, anyways. It has two seasons with 25 episodes each, and several movies, and a third season on the way. So trust me on this one, every episode will have you on the edge of your seat, thinking who's gonna do what next. Really liked it. For the next entry, we have Arpeggio of Blue Steel. Like Code Geass before, this one is also very tactical and smart. Also, if you know Kansai Collection, it's pretty much the same premise, except that there are both girls and ships, not just girls that have ship parts. It's a bit complicated if you don't get it, but just look it up, you'll understand. And yes, it is full 3D CG, but hear me out. The CG does not detract from the plot and actually makes some of the battles look top. Don't be turning it away just because it's 3D. I know, I don't like my 3D either. But I try to stomach it from time to time. It only has one season with 12 episodes, and as well as a movie that takes place after the main story, so make sure to watch that. Let's continue the theme of the ship, shall we? With Space Battleship Yamato 2199. Or how they call it in Japan, Star Blazers. It's a pretty cool title. Not talking about the original one, though. I never saw that one, but the animation, the voice acting might put people off. It's from 1978, so yeah, it's just really dated. But the new remake is just excellent. As you can tell from the title, yes, it is has a sci-fi centric plot. The Earth is a desolate wasteland due to aliens bombing the planet, and now humanity must travel a distant planet for aid. This one kind of took me by surprise. It's more than just like a space journey, but that's kind of the fun part of it. It's got conflicts both internally and externally, and it also shows us from the perspective of the not space Nazis, the aliens called the Gamilons. I was a bit hesitant to put this one on the list because, you know, it's mostly just around the ship, but overall, it kind of does have a military theme to it. It has 26 episodes and a movie, but it also has a continuation season of 26 episodes, which I actually just found out when I was making this, and I need to go finish that. You know it, you love it, it's Valkyria Chronicles. If you've been around the channel long enough, you know I'm a big fan of the Valkyria Chronicles franchise. This one's an adaptation of the first game. It takes place during the 1930s in a fictional Europe called, wait for it, Europa. Yes, it's very creative. So some people say the game is better, but personally I actually think the opposite of that. The anime feels more grounded and believable as you can get in this setting, because if you've seen it, you know some of the ridiculous things that happen during it. But what sells this anime most is the characters. Just like in the games, you're gonna care for each and every one of these guys by the end of the show, so, you know. as one season with 26 episodes and a two-part OVA about the third game, which I do recommend you watch regardless if you've played any of the games. Trust me, you'll have a much harder time trying to actually find and play the third game than just watching it. Now, moving on to something a bit less serious, we have Strike Witches. And before you start, you judgmental prick.
Just lolly fan service. Are you into that, dear?
Okay. Yes, it does have that. And if that distracts you, it's not my problem. But it's much more than that. It takes place in alternate World War II, where instead of us killing each other, it's frickin' aliens, man!
It was space aliens, man!
And because anime, the only way to fight them are with cute girls using magic. And guns, of course, lots of guns. This one, though, has bigger historical references than other anime, from the locations to the equipment, and of course how each witch is based on a real ace, which I really like. I could go on about all the individual details all day, but that's for some other time.
But dude, all this crap, it's a disrespect to the real pirate who fought and died in the war.
No, I call it Japan being Japan, and you being a wuss, but whatever. This one has two seasons with 12 episodes each, several OVAs, a spin-off, a movie, and another season on the way. Like I said, this one's not for everyone, so if it ain't your cup of tea, well, too bad! Well, since we're already on the cute girls doing military things, let's continue with Girls und Panzer, my personal favorite since I love tanks. If you thought Strike Witches was odd, well, how does schoolgirls driving tanks and shooting at each other sound? Yeah, great, I know, right? Surprisingly enough, well, this one also has a great deal of historical references, to the point where even the chieftain was one of the military advisors for it. Look, I'm gonna give it to you straight, alright? You like World War II tanks? Yes? Alright, then watch this and don't ask any questions. As one season with 12 episodes, an OVA, several specials, a movie, and an in-progress 6-part movie that's still airing.
We're still waiting for part 2, by the way!
Next on the list is something a little bit different, but also a little bit familiar. Izetta the Last Witch. This one's kind of strange since it just came out of nowhere one day. It takes place in an alternate European setting, much like Valkyria Chronicles, and has the whole magic aspect similar to Strike Witches. But don't let that detract you from the overall more dark and serious tone that the show has. When I first saw it, I was pretty hyped for it, but thought, it's just gonna have World War II as the backdrop, and it's not really gonna be paid much attention to, and it's just gonna be like some drama and something weird going on. Then I saw the actual anime, and I was like, oh wow, I was very wrong. This one blends the historical drama of the time with the whole magical thing really well. Sadly, it only has one season with 12 episodes. You thought I was done with the ridiculous premises? Well, ain't you wrong, boy! Let me tell you about a little something called Yujo Senki, or the Saga of Tanya the Evil. Okay, so this guy dies and gets sent to another world as a loli. Basic isekai, right? Okay, well, now what if I told you that this loli is basically frickin' Hitler? It takes place in what would be called the intermediate period between World War I and World War II. There's no real year, I think, that they say, but the setting and the politics are mostly World War I-esque, but some of the equipment they use later on is more from World War II. Oh yeah, they also mention how brutal it gets? Yeah, it doesn't hold back at times, and I love it. Josenki is one of my all-time favorite animes, and yes, this one does have magic in it too, but it blends it in so seamlessly that you don't really question it. It's just there, but it's part of the whole setting and the story, so, you know, they do that really well. It only has one season with 12 episodes and a movie set to release later on in the year. Hopefully. Okay, and finally, the last one I chose, my personal favorite, Gate. Thus the JSDF fucker, or simply Gate. To simplify things, imagine invading the world of Skyrim, but with modern military hardware like assault rifles, tanks, and helicopters. Well, that's basically what this anime is. It's all JSDF eye candy. So, a portal opens in the middle of Tokyo and a bunch of medieval warriors and monsters show up and start killing people, because that's what you do, right? 3 months later, the JSDF sends a recon task force through the gate to see what they're dealing with. While I am a man who likes his historical fiction, I also enjoy a bit of fantasy on the side. Gate mixes those two things just right. It has 2 seasons with 12 episodes each, and I enjoyed every single one of it. And that's all I have. That's my list of 10 military anime recommendations I have for you. And Deermas. And like I said before, this isn't a top 10 list. I did leave out a few for the sake of time, so don't go berating me about why a certain show wasn't on here and blah blah blah. Alright? Heck, I might not have even seen it. This is all just stuff I've seen. It's my own personal wrong opinions. Alright? So with that said, thank you for watching. You're all fantastic. And I'll see you next episode.